Well, I'm not sure how well I can get through this. I'm never sure. But it's great that I've gone over the 150 subscribers mark. And it's a real privilege for me to be able to speak with you on this channel. So it's the one thing that keeps me going, really, because it's the only thing that really interests me. The rest of life, I had no interest in it. I could probably do this 24/7, but that's a little too much content for anybody. So welcome to the video, and I don't know what I'm going to speak about. I do know there's a big heat wave coming to Southern California very soon, end of September, and the beginning of October. And there may be a spiritual heat wave coming to the USA, certainly in November there will, and in the world in general. I believe a crisis will happen in Greece, continued crisis and problems with Greece, maybe even World War III, starting in Greece in that area is very possible. The conditions in the Middle East, including Greece and Turkey and all of that stuff, you know, is ripe for big trouble. So when things heat up, what do we do? What do we do? It's very simple. First of all, we have to connect with right advice, right example, right presence. And we have to realize that there's a responsibility involved. To fulfill one's responsibility, one has to really go beyond belief. Another way of putting it is to step out of time. Step out of time. Same thing, going beyond belief. There is this step that can be taken and must be taken, no matter what is happening in the world. And what we're trying to do here is we are trying to gain momentum towards that. Gain momentum. Every day should be a day of momentum, continuing your momentum. Keep pushing that car until it finally starts. So we want to build up as much momentum as possible here towards continuously reminding ourselves that there is one simple remedy for us. Is there a remedy for the world? Is there a remedy for belief? Well, the only remedy for belief is to step out of belief. Belief cannot step out of itself. So the one who is doing the believing must step out. So the world can't step out of itself. The one who believes in the world can step out of the world, so to speak. Step out of the belief in a world. The belief in a person. Belief in existence, the belief, all the entire belief system, all beliefs. The one who is doing that believing, who's giving rise to that believing, can step out of it. And realize that what one is not a product of belief. So what we need to do can be done. And it will be done, and in order to do that, we must continually push momentum, 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 every day. It's never easy. It's work. It's tough work. No matter what happens in this election time in the USA, about half of the country is going to be irreversibly devastated one way or the other and simply not accept whatever happens. And the polarization is just going to go off the charts, and the collective consciousness of the world, you know, is just going to unravel. And all of that is actually planned. I actually saw a couple nights ago, I had this dream, and I was able to get out of this situation in time. And then looking back, I saw what happened. And there's like this laundry list. Okay, how I say is the goddess of destructivity. The dynamic aspect of the belief system that has a laundry list of things that need to be done, to, you know, destructive acts that need to take place in order to attempt to further the agenda of the belief system that we call existence. And this one had this long laundry list of all these hits that needed to take place, all these destructive events needed to take place, and they were just checking them off one after the other, or the other, or the other, like that. And I said, oh my gosh, how amazing I got out in time. Or, to put it a better way, how amazing I got out of time. Okay, get out of time. And we can explain this very, very clearly here. Failure to get out of time, and you are going to experience this hit list. We think that the events are just random, chaotic. No. There are blueprints. There's a list, a checklist of events to take place, and they will take place one after the other after the other. And all of this can be understood and clearly seen. All of it can be put in the right context. That's not a problem. The difficulty is to actually step out of time. That's the difficulty. Clarification of all of what's going on, I can do that easily. But stepping out of time is proving to be a bit of a sticky wicket. There's some kind of general reluctance to do so. And it's kind of like it's hard to bring it into focus. It's a little fuzzy. A generalized sense of reluctance to do so. And everybody struggles with that. And those who do step out of time, they do their best to help, but everyone still struggles. So it's not like there's some magic pill out there that will enable you to step out of time. It's impossible for there to be any some kind of magic pill or operation, or sit in a bathtub or a jacuzzi or whatever, or do chanting and breathing and all this stuff. That won't get it done. That can be part of one's work on it, yeah. But stepping out of time is something that if many start to do it, it's going to help. I believe it's going to help, because there's a lot of people in the world are working on this from different angles, and if there are those who start stepping out of time, this is going to accelerate. Everyone's going to say, ah, yeah, it is possible. It is doable. And this really needs to take place, I believe, in October this year. It really does. No later than that. Before the election, for sure. So I'm going as fast as possible without, trying to push things too fast, which causes a slowdown, actually. To step out of time, go beyond belief. And the function is to show people that everything's okay, it's fine. What we are has never been damaged at all. Therefore, it doesn't need to be fixed up at all. Therefore, it's fine right now. It doesn't need a future. So all this stuff that's going to happen isn't needed. It isn't needed. And by radiating this out into the world, it may have some kind of helpful effect the realization can spread that none of this is needed. The future isn't needed. We don't need time. We don't need the future. And if we don't need the future, that could lessen the intensity, you know, for everyone. It's possible. What we are has never needed time, never. And all the other videos I've made, you know, put the context into all context into what's being said here. The question is, going forward, October, which is the pre-election month, really. And again, there will be no winners in the election. The country's going to lose, and the world is going to lose, no matter what happens. No matter what happens. There's going to be a sense, half the people are going to have a sense of that they have, you know, irretrievably lost their future, you know. So it's extremely important that there's a realization building that nobody needs a future. We don't need a future. And I believe that what I've been doing and all the work I've done in my life is to help out during this time with that. Because the disillusionment is going to be so severe that I don't think anyone has even a much of a clue as to how bad it's going to be, no matter who wins. Because everything is at stake. All the chips are on the table. It's the final table. It's the final hand. All the chips are on the table. You know, there's going to be one gigantic winner and one total loser. And the total loser, you know, is just going to not accept it. And they're going to feel like they have no future. They have no future. And that can be just a mind-blowing thing, terrible thing. That's when people then just start acting out this blind rage. You know, if you see a good future, why would you just start acting out in blind rage? You would not, right? But for many, they're not going to see a good future, not going to see any future. So, what is incredibly important is that there be those in the world who assure the world that the future isn't needed. No future is needed at all. It never was needed. Time was never needed. Except we wanted to change what we were. We wanted to change ourselves from spirit to prime creator. Okay, we had that desire, and that's what gave rise to all this trouble, to time, and to all the troubles that time has displayed. But the fact is, we can't change ourselves. We can't change reality. We can't make ourselves prime creator. So none of it was necessary. None of it. And it remains completely unnecessary. 100% unnecessary. So I don't know what I can do or how things will work out for me. I really don't. I expect something will work out, but the universe is maliciously contrarian, really, and it tends to, if you expect something, it will try and make sure you don't get what you expect. And if you don't expect something, it'll try to get what you don't expect, simply to try and make you believe that nothing is set in stone, that there is no reality, that reality is changeable. The central belief that trips us up, that keeps us, that gives rise to the whole belief system, that gives rise to belief itself, is the belief that reality can be changed. That is the central premise, and it's a false premise. So everything that rests on a false premise can't possibly be true. Cannot possibly be true, no matter how you spin it. And what is not true doesn't have any value. Reality cannot be changed. Cannot be changed. So all our belief is based on that reality can be changed. All of that then is simply nothing. It's invalid, useless, waste of time, aimless, wandering around aimlessly. We don't need a future to make truth true, do we? Truth is already true. It's always been true. We really don't need a future. And so I realize that many are wanting to step out of time now. Not suicide. No. Step out of time, which means abide in the presence, the I am presence of isness through unconditional love right now, that is here right now, that we are overlooking because we are thinking that that the future is necessary, that something has to happen first. Nothing has to happen first. Nothing. Nothing has to happen first. Nothing has to happen at all. We don't need to do anything to be what we already are. And there is definitely protection there for those who have let go of time. I call it the Passover principle. It is they cannot be harmed. Jesus said that not a hair on his head could even be touched if it wasn't that for the fact that he was here to dramatize and symbolize the situation for those who were best reached in that way. Otherwise, no harm could befall at all because of the Passover principle. So, and it works probably in degrees. The more aligned one is towards stepping out of time, the more of a Passover effect there will be. Stepping out of time, going beyond belief, that brings about a total Passover principle. But if one is very much aligned in that direction, there will be some Passover principle at work. So the trauma will be lessened, the troubles will be lessened for those who are like that. And if this, the more this spreads throughout the world, the more the trauma is lessened, actually. Now it can come back, but it gives an opportunity for those to turn towards the spiritual path of stepping out of time. It gives the opportunity. That's all. But if they decide, they don't want to do it, then of course the trauma will be rebuilt. No question about it. So I would say that people really have a strong responsibility to align themselves with situations that help them towards stepping out of time, help them to step beyond belief, out of belief, out of all beliefs, into what is, what already is the case. And I need to do more, that is for sure. That is for sure. I don't feel I'm nearly doing enough. Just kind of warming up, but really more needs to be done. Because we're down to it now. We're almost to October. That is the last chance to get started, really. There has to be momentum before the election. You cannot build the momentum after the election. Okay? These videos here are building some momentum for those who are watching them, and certainly for me who is making the videos. But there has to be significantly more momentum in place before the elections take place in the United States. What is it, November 6th? Something like that. First week of November. First Tuesday of November. There has to be profound momentum in place. It could even be done through videos, you know, in some way. And it won't happen through very artful videos. You know, I've been exploring that. I've been exploring that, thinking like, I can certainly do it. I mean, I have all the skills to do very sophisticated videos, but it's extremely time consuming. And what I believe is that it's not the right, it's not the answer. Because in looking at other videos on YouTube, spiritual videos that use high production quality, high quality production techniques, they don't hold my attention. They really don't. And so I said no to that. The other option would be to make videos about other past great teachers, like Ananda Maharmana Maharshi, that kind of thing. And I could do that too. Absolutely could do that. Very, very capably. But again, in looking at that, I've decided that's not the answer either. We need those who are here right now, who have stepped beyond time, beyond belief, under these circumstances. It's all important, under these circumstances. And then for that, just to then come on strong and build momentum. So I am continuing with these very simple, basic format talks, which don't cause me my eyes problems with my concentration with my eyes, and fatigue and consumed time and all, because I have to, you know, have a busy life otherwise that's full of responsibility. So this is just live, you know. There's no editing. There's no pausing, no editing, nothing, just live. And once it's done, it's done. I'm able to do that, get the time in the evening, sometimes in the mornings, on weekends. But it takes a big push, a big push. And a big push can only come from one who has stepped out of time, who's gone beyond belief. That's it. Can't come from anywhere else. But we will require that in October. It'll be required. There is simply no way that we can go into November still only at the conceptual level. There is no way. Our voices will shrink up. We'll lose our voices. Really, we have a golden opportunity. We have had a golden opportunity up until this point, but that'll be over. Come the election, the situation will be such that it'll become difficult to express these things just conceptually. There has to be something much greater behind it. Otherwise, the speech won't go out. The witnessing won't be able to go out. And people will shrink up. They'll shrink into a shell. Shrink into a shell. We'll become just shells of ourselves if we don't have that momentum. So there's a lot of pressure. I feel a lot of pressure. Trying to... I was at this place and a couple days ago, and there were thousands of birds on a hillside, thousands of them, seagulls. And I had a video camera, and the video camera was on because I knew they were going to take off, because at some point the people there shoot off a flare that scares them away. And the same man, so I was waiting, and they didn't take off. And I had to drive again. I was stopped, and I said, wow, I better just turn the camera off, you know. Okay, I'm going to miss it this time. And wouldn't you know it, just a little bit later, boom, the flare went off, and all the seagulls en masse took off from this hill going right straight at me. And it was unbelievable, and they all flew, and you could hear, I had the window open, you could hear the rush of the wings, whoosh, as this armada of seagulls just whoosh, flew right over right over me, right over the truck. It was awesome. And I grabbed the camera and I turned it on, and I tried to grab a stuff, but later I looked back and I forgot to press record. Or I pressed it twice and it missed it. I didn't record it. I was wondering, wow, I missed it. I didn't get it for you guys. You know. And I've been, you know, had to contemplate this. What does that mean? And there's something there. Special effects, dramatic stuff is not going to get it done. It's not going to happen through something superficial, even though it may be dramatic. It's not going to happen that way. It will happen when we turn something off. In other words, turn the desire, some kind of desire to make a future, so to speak. To capture the future somehow. We have to be willing to drop the future. And that puts us in a different situation. And when we do that, we'll be able to take off. There will be a massive takeoff, as it were, into the now, into the I am presence of isness, and to spin beyond belief. There will be this takeoff, but it will only happen when we are well. I wonder if that flare, that boom, explosion that startled all the seagulls, maybe that's the election that's coming up. Maybe that's the election that's coming up that is, you know, we're just going to, whoa, be, you know, everyone is really going to take off. Or maybe I need to stop making videos. I don't know. That might be part of it too. I don't know. Maybe others can take videos at some point. Maybe I have to, you know, graduate to the next level. And maybe situations will arise where I might, you know, be with some people and they can, you know, take videos. Everybody's got a video camera these days, a smartphone or webcam, flip cams, video cams, all sorts of recording devices. I don't know. That might be possible. That might be it. Interesting. Because again, we do have a deadline. There is a deadline. It's an unmistakable deadline. There is no way that either side is going to accept defeat. No way. Because it literally is accepting the end of their expectations of the future, their destiny. It's like a spiritual death sentence. So they won't be able to believe in the future. They won't be able to believe in it. And they will be staggered and lose belief in this feeling of this terrible things. But what you have to do is you have to see the root of belief. You have to know what belief really is. What is belief? It's a denial of what is. It's a denial of what is. And we have to insulate ourselves from this collapse of belief in the future. Stepping beyond belief is not a collapse of belief. Collapse of belief brings about depression and what's it called? Acting out in just frantic, chaotic, violent ways, you know. Running amok. I think they call it running amok. You know, the world just simply will run amok because when you have no future, you run amok. When you believe you need a future, but you don't have one, then you run amok. That's what happens. It's only when you realize you don't need a future, where then you abide in peace. It's the opposite of running amok. So really, the world is going to go either, some are going to go amok, and some are going to go towards peace. And you're going to get dragged one way or the other. You're going to decide, well, wait a minute, I don't want to go run amok. I'm really going to go all in with peace. And others will frantically try to just run amok because they believe they need a future. And yet they feel that they're not going to have one. And that just triggers this reactions. Triggers wars. Triggers world wars is what it does. That feeling, that contagion of no future, needing a future but not having one, that spreads. And there's so many people in the world now that feel they don't have a future. Future is very, very, very precarious and seems to be evaporating like a mirage. And so they got nothing to lose. You know, they just say, why not seize what others have? Why not seize others' futures? You see? Why not seize the future from others? Because those who think they do have a real nice future, others who don't have any, they're going to try to seize it. That's what, when wars break out, that's what happens. The remedy is, of course, to realize you don't need a future. You've never needed time. What you are doesn't need time. Doesn't need any future. You're already perfect. You're already complete. You're already holy. You're whole. You're not missing anything. You're not damaged. You're not harmed. You're not oppressed. You're not victimized. You're flawless isness. You already are that. And going towards this realization, it's a realization beyond time, beyond belief. Belief cannot believe in that. Belief cannot believe in holiness. It can believe in a process towards holiness, okay? A process towards it. It does believe in that, but it doesn't believe in holiness right now. Okay. And it will never believe in holiness right now. Never. Only in the future. So when belief tries to get all spiritual on you, realize it's always in the future. And if it tries to put it in the past, you'll need a future to get back to that past too. So it's still in the future, always in the future. So the belief will say, oh yeah, you can be holy, you know, you can be divine, you can be enlightened, you can be realized, you can step out of time, blah, 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 blah. But it's always in the future. You can't do it right now. Never, never now. Belief is a way of saying never now. And it will always, always put it in the future. So what good does it do to keep going along with belief? You will only see yourself in the future, but never now. And when that future gets taken away from you by various events and situations in the world, then you think you'll never get to yourself. You'll never arrive at yourself. So what are you going to do? You're going to steal someone else's future. You're going to attack. You're going to find some way to attack someone else's future. So you can see, it is a nasty situation we're going into. Let us not sugarcoat it in the slightest bit. You can already feel the desperation is intense in the world. And I think most people are simply holding their breath and hoping that it won't get any worse, and yet it keeps getting worse and worse and worse. Because a lot of futures are being stolen, they are being taken, they are being crushed, they're being burned up. And so people without a future, who think they need a future to become what they are, they're going to become desperate, and desperate people take desperate measures. Period. Super desperate people take super desperate measures. And you've got you've got a situation that's going to morph into super desperation on many levels here, many levels. Not just material, ideological. Very much so ideological. Moral, ethical, spiritual, intellectual, emotional, the whole thing. The whole gamut of situations now. You know, there's a parting of the ways, the road parts like that. There's a fork in the road coming up, a fork in the road, November, a fork in the road will be taken, you know, they'll be there, the road forks. And certainly we don't want to put that time to the test, believing that we need a future. Absolutely not, absolutely not. And people are trying to assess who's going to win the future, you know, and trying to jump on that bandwagon just so they think they're going to have a future. But there are many people who cannot jump on bandwagons at this time. They're too invested in their vision of the future. So they will lose and lose big, like a free fall. And there'll be plenty of bandwagoners, you know, who are just trying to... But bandwagoners will find their own situation not very good at all either, because they're really not committed. The answer is satsang, inquiry, abiding in the presence. Darshan is another thing, which is just the viewing of the presence, being in the presence. Contemplation, prayer, meditation, all aligned though towards going beyond belief, realizing the truth of the situation we're in, putting it all in the right context, and realizing we don't need any future. We are doesn't need a future. It's perfect already. But if we haven't realized this, we are going to be in a situation where we are faced with enormous pulls in different directions, powerful pulls, one into despair, to desperate acts of desperation, or the other into desperately trying to solidify their power and crushing the opposition to make sure the opposition doesn't steal their future from them. You see, it is going to be terrible. Because each one realizes that, you know, whoever wins, that their win is extreme. And therefore they know the others are going to be desperate. And therefore they know the others are going to try and steal the future from them. And therefore they feel in order to protect their future, they're going to have to really crush the opposition. Really ruthlessly crush them. Which then is the entire dynamic of a war. Entire dynamic is there. Because war is ruthless crushing, isn't it? It's the point where ruthless crushing takes place. And there were previous steps up to that. But what happens is when someone really feels that they have, you know, no future, and those who have a future are trying to absolutely eliminate their future 100% so they don't have any chance to bounce back and steal the other's future, that's when war breaks out, really. And people decide they're going to have to take extreme means to try and get a future or to protect their future. And then you got this terrible conflict, you know. I mean, Germany in World War One, after World War One, in between the wars, the people there got the feeling they had no future. They had no future, and they felt that it was going to be completely eliminated if they didn't take drastic steps. And so they took drastic steps. They really did, and they were determined to make sure that could never happen to them again. So the drastic steps were very, very drastic. then, but what we're coming up upon here is more drastic, actually, on a worldwide basis. Way more drastic. So we really have to have the momentum before the election, which is why I've been slaving away for so long to try and make a push, you know, the big boost, make a push. And these videos are certainly a push, but not, you know, the big push. It's not enough. And again, the push has to come before the elections. After the elections, people are going, the agitation is going to become so extreme. You know, it's too late. People won't be able to focus. Right now, we say, well, we don't know what's going to happen. We don't know who the winners, losers are. You know, we're not sure. So we're not as agitated right now. And there hasn't been an October surprise yet. You know, there hasn't been, war hasn't broken out. All these things haven't taken place. You know, I don't know for sure if there'll be an October surprise. It wouldn't be a surprise if there were. We need to have our own October surprise, which is going beyond belief, stepping out of time. And of course, those who feel they're going to be on the winning side don't see any reason for this, but they're very ignorant because they don't realize that whatever they have, their future is going to be targeted by those who feel they don't have any future. And that therefore they will be swept up in an attempt to crush the opposition, crush them, and they will end up becoming very nasty on their own accord, way worse than they bargained for. So a lot of people think they just want to be good people, they just want to go along, jump on the bandwagon, have a good future, and they think, that's fine, that's okay. Not true. Look, world wars pull everybody into the war, okay? It becomes everybody's war. It affects everybody. So just being on the winning side is folly. I'm saying no matter what happens, the dynamics will engulf everyone, except those who have stepped out of time, gone beyond belief, and those who are committed to that. So I'm trying to, you know, find out what are the remaining, you know, strings. It's like Gulliver's travel. Gulliver's tied down by all these little tiny Lilliputian strings. And, you know, they're just trying to get up, and there's still, you know, a few need to snip here and there and get free. It's, of course, it's going to be misinterpreted by those who think they'll be on the winning side. They'll think that anyone who's not going with them must be against them. You know, they don't understand that there's a big difference between those who think they've been dispossessed of a future and those who realize they don't need any future and are perfectly happy with that. There's a huge, huge, immeasurably large difference, but they don't, I don't think people really realize that. But we have to realize it. And with the grace of God, something can be done. But there's no question that, you know, the time has come. There was a massive amount of seagulls that took off, I'll tell you that. Interesting. I would say, I don't know how many, but maybe thousands, you know. It's pretty incredible. They're thick. The sky was thick with them, so much that, you know, the rushing of wings was like almost a roar. So there are plenty of people in the world who want to step beyond belief. Plenty of people. But they're all waiting. You know, they're waiting. Everybody's just waiting. It's hard. It's hard to break the inertia. Breaking inertia is really difficult. It's easy to follow. It's hard to lead because, you know, breaking the inertia, you know, is just like, you know, can it happen? That's the kind of thing. We don't know. It's almost like we have to make it happen instead of just following along with what is happening. We need to actually make it happen. And that's a different situation. And right now, it's not happening in the world. It's not happening. Because we have to do it ahead of time. It's not, you know, there are those who are saying, well, I will do it in the future, you know. Too late then. Too late. What is difficult is to do it ahead of time, having enough conviction of this is what's going to happen, definitely going to happen, therefore I definitely need to do this now. You know, don't wait. That is the tough part. Hindsight is 20/20. So once you see all hell break loose and there's problems, and you say, oh, wow, I really need to do something about it. Too late, then. It's too late. Because the agitation already will be overwhelming. And you'll start trying to clutch at safety and you know, not realize where the safety is. The momentum won't be there. Some momentum has to be here in the world, really has to. And it's not, I don't see it yet. But it can happen. The only thing that's important is that it starts. It starts in October. It has to start in October. It doesn't have to be big, it just has to start. So we're running out of time for sure. We've run out of time, which is a good thing to realize. And the thing is, very few realize it, that we've run out of time. And this is decision time. I mean, September is decision time. October is momentum time. August was moving time. September was decision time. October is momentum time. That is it. Fortunately, October is my lucky month. Always has been. And the greatest things, the greatest breakthroughs always happen in October. So I trust in October. I trust in a positive October surprise. The truly transcendent events, the times when I have stepped out of time, have always been in October. I don't know why. Maybe in preparation for this year, possibly, you know. I remember 1978, 1997. Those are a couple of the times. Other times as well, other years as well, more recently, where stepping out of time, going beyond belief, occurred in October. The difference here is that it has to be permanent. Those are temporary. It has to be permanent. As soon as one steps back into time, one into the future, one is believing they need a future to be what they are, and then they will be right again within time, seeing everything that's happening, thinking that this has something to do with what they are, this is consequential to what they are, and then poof, they lose their clarity like that and freak out. But this time, once you step out of time, at this, you cannot go back into time without the wheels just coming off, really coming off right now. So it has to be a permanent thing. It has to be a permanent situation. It maybe that's why it's difficult. Because I realize that, you know, just stepping for a moment or something, it's not going to do it right now. It's not going to do it. It provides conceptual boost. It does not provide the momentum we need in the world right now. It does not. Conceptual boost is not enough at this point. Starting in October, it's not enough. Has to be permanent, stepping out of time, going beyond belief. Not a temporary thing. That's something that you go in and go out. You got to get in the pool. You got to swim in the pool. You can't just dip your toe. You know, that's it. You have to get into the pool and stay in there. So I expect to be able to resolve these issues. At some point to say, okay, come on, let's get going here. Let's get going. It's only the first few steps that are difficult, you know. Once those first two steps are taken, it's not difficult at all. But, the first couple steps have to be taken. But we'll do it. We'll definitely do it. We'll get some momentum going before the election. Some real momentum. More than conceptual. More than conceptual. And there's a big difference. Big difference, I'm telling you. Big difference. Conceptual, you know you have conceptual momentum. But when you have that which is beyond belief, and not within time at all, you know that you have something. You have a world beater. You have world beater. You have escape velocity momentum. You realize it. You have escape velocity momentum, which is a whole different thing. And then you just say, it doesn't matter what's happening in the world. I don't need to be bothered by it. I don't need what is happening in the world to reach any conclusion at all. Good, bad, and different makes no difference. The outcomes don't make any difference at all. Because I don't need a future at all. Not in belief. I don't need a future in belief. Now extends eternally, you see. I will always have the now. So what do I need a future for? I can never lose what I am right now. So what do I need a future for? What do I need these events, this process, this trauma, this change, what do I need that for? I don't need it. So all the stuff that's happening, it's just inconsequential, irrelevant, unimportant, all of that. And that can definitely be reached and needs to be reached. Certainly trending in that direction with momentum, trending with momentum. Just conceptual is going to be cut off right very soon. A little over a month's time. If you're just on the conceptual level, you know, you're toast. You're really toast. I think we all realize that at this, you know, starting to get this building realization that we have to have this deeper momentum going for us. Have to have it. So we have the time. I mean, we time is very urgent, but it's doable. It's still doable. Okay, so we will keep focusing on getting that that deeper momentum going. In the meantime, also keep your conceptual clarity going and focus your intent, that realizing that you do need deeper momentum coming up in the next month's time. Okay, very important. All right, very great. That's it for this video.